Okay, fine. So students, I am starting. First question is in front of you. Anhydrous copper sulfate can be made by hydrated copper sulfate, which can be added in anhydrous copper sulfate to turn into hydrated one. To turn into hydrated one. 100% accuracy expected. Yes, I think. Anhydrous copper sulfate you have, and you need hydrated one. Fine. All questions, in all the questions, you have only 1 minute. Okay. Now, just a minute. I think most of you have done right only. Answer is D. Okay, fine. A is not the answer. Answer is D only. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. Answer is D. I'll change it. Don't worry. Okay. I'll change it in 1 minute. Just a minute. Okay, fine. Answer is D only. Answer is water. So now those who have answered it water, it's all correct. Okay, fine. Now moving to the next question. So any doubt, whenever you have anhydrous, because while reading the question, I read it other way around. Like I read it like how to convert hydrated to anhydrous. How to convert hydrated into anhydrous? Any idea? Anyone who can tell me hydrated into anhydrous? Okay, you can heat it. What else? What else? Okay, can you add concentrated H2SO4 also? Yes? Okay, fine. Students, you can see my screen now. Okay, fine. So those who have answered it, this I have marked it right. Okay, answer is D only. Moving to the next question. Don't worry, quiz is not closed. Can you see my screen, all of you? Yes. Could I move to the next question? Yes or no? Fine. Next question. Which of the following is true for HCl gas is passed through water? When HCl is passed through water. Okay, students, option 1, 2, 3, 4 represent ABCD. HCl gas is passed through water. Okay, it's very easy question and I think you all can answer. So in last question we did not get 100%, so I'm not expecting 100% in this also, but at least I am expecting good percentage of right answers. Let us see what is going to happen in this question. Everyone voted and answer is C. Very good students, it gives you hydronium ion and that's it. It gives you hydronium ion. Any doubt in this question? It don't give you OH minus ion. Gives you hydronium ion. No doubt. I'm moving to the next question. Fine. We'll see the leaderboard and then we'll move to the next one. If anyone has a small doubt, you all can ask at any time. Okay. Okay. Good, Aryan. Yashash. Sai. Moving to the next one. This question says, identify the correct representation of reaction occurring during chloralkali process. Chloralkali process is some process in which you make sodium hydroxide using NaCl. So according to you, what should be the answer? Think chloralkali process. It is very important question as far as NCRT is concerned. or CBSE is concerned. Don't worry, Memo. You should be very perfect in answering this question. If you are taking time, it's fine, but don't make mistake. You have 26 more seconds left to answer this question. Chlor-alkali process. You know, it is a very important process because you take NaCl and water to make the sodium hydroxide and chlorine and hydrogen. And we are going to see, yes, we are going to see the answers. Answer is D, my dear students. Do you want me to explain? Do you want me to explain this question? Explain. Okay, fine. So moving to the question. So this is the question, if you see. This is the question. Identify the correct representation of the reaction occurring. So question is very easy. Most of you have marked answer C. I don't know why you have marked answer C. Answer is D. You take an aqueous solution. Whenever you take water, aqueous solution of NaCl is there. And why you are writing Cl to aqueous? You know, actually electrolysis happens. This is electrolysis is carried out for NaCl. So you get two gases, Cl2 gas and H2 gas. One at cathode and one at anode. Which will release at anode and which will release at cathode? Who will answer? What will be the product at cathode and anode? Try to understand this. Cl minus, you have NaCl. Cl minus is going to Cl2. Is it oxidation or reduction? Cl minus to Cl2 is oxidation or reduction? Change in oxidation number, increase in oxidation number is oxidation. Increase in oxidation number is oxidation. Oxidation always happen at anode. Always remember, I remember it like OA, OA. Oxidation always happen at anode. So at anode you will get chlorine gas. And at cathode H plus, because you have taken H2O, it is H plus. And it is giving you hydrogen gas. Yes, tell me. Yes, Samrat, do you want to say something? H plus is going to H2. Reduce in oxidation number, plus 1 to 0. If plus 1 to 0, it is reduction. And reduction happens at cathode. So it is H2 gas. Both are gases and both are not soluble in water. So that's why I gave this question. Is it clear to all of you? Question seems very easy. But you can see that answer is just 35%. Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. Hope you learned these things. With the help of this question, I have told you little bit about electrolysis. OA thing, oxidation always at anode. Oxidation means change in oxidation number. Increase in oxidation number is oxidation. Chloride ion, hydronium ion. H plus, a hydrogen ion and chloride ion. Hope you understood this. Moving to the next question. If anyone has a small doubt, please ask. Otherwise, I'll move to the next question. Next question is in front of us. We'll see the leaderboard and then we'll move to the next one. Are you all ready for next question? Yes, very good, Abhipsha, Aryan, Varsha, good. Okay. Varsha is from which batch? Varsha, are you also from CHK? CHK? Okay. So all CHK students are leading as of now. Good students. But don't worry students, all other students you can. It may be new for you. Many of you don't know these concepts also. Don't worry. You can learn now. I know that I have not covered these things in class, but you can learn it now. Bleaching powder is soluble in cold water giving a milky solution due to. Giving a milky solution, bleaching powder. Now you would think, sir, what is bleaching powder? To help you, bleaching powder is CaOCl2. Now think. And something is milky. milky solution is forming. You can think of it. Okay, students. Answer is nothing but B. Fourth answer is B. Oh my God. Fine. Now see how to answer this question. So question is this. Bleaching powder. You know what is bleaching powder? Bleaching powder is CaOCl2. It formed with the help of CaOH whole twice plus CaCl2. These are the two components which makes bleaching powder. This is bleaching powder. If you want to know what is cation and anion, cation is Ca plus 2. Two anions are there. OCl minus and Cl minus. There are two anions in bleaching powder. OCl minus and Cl minus. Now this is a bleaching powder. Okay. Lime present in it. Yes. You know this is the reason why carbon dioxide when passed through lime water it turns milky. Do you, all of you remember I think. Yes. Okay. There calcium carbonate forms. But lime cold water giving a milky solution because of presence of lime. Okay. So lime is present which gives the solution milky. Yes. So. Okay, now bleaching, yes, in cold water you will get the this thing because lime is present and with the cold water you will get the turbid solution. Okay, 1 minute, just a minute. Okay, fine. So those, I think many of you have not learned the reaction of bleaching powder with any other solution. So, but you can understand it. See, just a minute. Okay, see, what happens when you have the bleaching powder, it is formulated CaOCl2. So here also you will get the Chlorine is there. Chlorine is there, which is creating a solution. You know the properties of bleaching powder. Okay, I will do one thing. I'll explain this after in the last of that. Okay, I want to explain 2-3 properties of bleaching powder. I will explain all those things at one time only. Otherwise, I think I should first finish that. Then I will come to this. Don't worry, I will come to this question again. Okay. First, we'll finish this, then I'll explain 2-3 properties of bleaching powder, so that will clear all your doubts. Okay, so, okay, one, so next question, we'll come to that. Next question is plaster of Paris is made up of. Very easy question. Yes. So you have 30 more seconds. Okay, students, most of you got it right. Very good. We'll see the leaderboard first, then we'll move to the next question. Okay, fine. This was very easy question, but still I didn't get 100%. Okay, washing soda. Washing soda has the formula. You know, bleaching powder, washing soda, all these are very important compounds. And this is a very famous compound also because of its water of crystallization. Because of its water of crystallization, this compound is very, very important. Okay, now, so answer for this question is sodium carbonate plus .10H2O, very, very important compound. Sodium carbonate .10H2O, don't write any number of H2O. These H2O are known as water of crystallization. I explained in first chapter also. I explained in first chapter that it is water of crystallization and it is fixed in number. So .10H2O is the correct answer. Na2CO3 .10H2O. Is it clear to all of you? Could we move to next question? Yes or no? Fine. Okay, what is the green vitriol? Formula of green vitriol? Green vitriol formula. Who all can answer? No. Okay, very good. FeSO4.7H2O. That is the green vitriol. The 7 is very important. What is blue vitriol? Blue vitriol. Very good. Here you have 5H2O. So remember these numbers. It is very important. Very good, students. Moving to the next question. Please read question carefully before answering. Plaster of Paris hardened by. Plaster of Paris hardened by. Those who don't have any idea, for them I will tell you, plaster of Paris is nothing but a hemihydrated calcium sulfate. Hemihydrated calcium sulfate. How to harden it? If you have ever seen the plaster of Paris, you must be able to answer this question. Plaster of Paris is hardened by which process? Okay. You have 10 more seconds. Okay. Answer is, if you add a small amount of water, you know what happens with the plaster of Paris? Okay, I'll tell you. Just a minute. What happens with plaster of Paris? You know, this is the question. You know, plaster of Paris is nothing but calcium sulfate hemihydrate. What is calcium sulfate hemihydrate? It is something like CaSO4. What is the formula of plaster of Paris? Who all can answer? First, for our plaster of Paris, very good. .½H2O. This is plaster of Paris. When it combined with 1.5 molecules of water, it forms something called as gypsum. Very good. It forms gypsum. Okay, KRM students, don't worry. I know that you people don't know this, but you will learn all this, and now you can learn this. It is nothing but gypsum. Is it clear? Yes or no? Fine. Moving to the next. It's a very hard. It's very hard. Okay. This is not that much hard. There is some hydrogen bonding and all are the reasons. Will not go in that detailing part. You know, once it was asked that draw the structure of calcium sulfate .5H2O, it was asked in JEE, IIT JEE. Its structure is very much complicated, but later you will understand. Yes, exactly. Water is given out. You know, when you want to make plaster of Paris, you need to heat it. When you make plaster, this is called as POP also. Plaster of Paris or POP. When you heat it, you will get the gypsum. When you heat gypsum, you will get POP. And when you add water, you will get gypsum. Yes, by losing water at 373 Kelvin. Exactly. Okay, now try to understand. You have to be very much careful while heating the gypsum to obtain POP because you need half water of crystallization. If you keep on heating, what will happen? The whole water molecule will go out and you will get anhydrous calcium sulfate. You will get anhydrous calcium sulfate if you keep on heating this. And on further heating, you will definitely lose your calcium sulfate will also start dissociating. Is it clear? You are adding water, you are not giving out water. I hope you understood this. All of you understood? Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Very good, Srijani, Aniket, Meghna, Abhiksha. Good going. Oh, very good, Srijani. Fine. Moving to the next question. A solution reacts with crushed egg shells to give a gas that turns lime water milky. The solution contains. Very easy question. You need to think little bit in this. Okay. Why, Srijani? Okay, common sense will answer here. Yes, you can say that, but still, fine. Though I discuss this question, this type of question, you know, egg cells have calcium carbonate. Egg cells have calcium carbonate, and when you make calcium carbonate react with HCl, you will get H2CO3. Do you remember this reaction? Do you remember this reaction? Just a minute, students. You remember this? Calcium carbonate with HCl gives you, what is the product? CaCl2, balance it, plus H2CO3 will form by double displacement. By double displacement, H2CO3 will form. But H2CO3 will break down into H2O and CO2. And this turns lime water milky. Lime water milky. Now, like lime water is CaOH whole twice. And when it is react with CO2, you will get CaCO3. Okay? Lime water milky. Is it clear to all of you? Okay? Now, you know, in the previous where we discussed the lime water, there also you got the milky solution. Actually, this lime water is also a little bit white. It is not purely soluble in water. So those students who were asking, sir, because of formation of calcium carbonate in the question number 2, there was no carbon source of carbon. So there is no point of formation of calcium carbonate because you took bleaching powder, CaOCl2. There is no carbon in that. But this CaOCl2 also break into CaOH whole twice and HOCl. This is also milky. This is also milky, or if you see this lime water, it is having a white color. So this is also milky, but calcium carbonate is milky white, precipitate will form, turbidity will appear. Understood? So whenever you want to test CO2, you pass it through calcium hydroxide. You will get calcium carbonate white PPT. This is precipitate. This is not precipitate. This is less soluble base. Where, you know, that's why we say calcium hydroxides are very less soluble base. It is less soluble means something remain undissolved. That is white in color. Hope you understood this. Would I move to next question? Yes or no? Hello? Okay, fine. Any doubt? Any doubt? No? Fine. Moving to next question. First, we'll see the result. Okay, it seems like Meghna is leading this time. Aniket Gupta. Very good, Aniket. Aniket, which batch? Okay. Alums is an example of. Now, if you know about alums, then only you can answer this question. If you don't know, you can't answer this question. So, if you have ever heard about alums, these are also salts. Alums are also kind of salts. It could be acids also, you think, if you have heard about this. Okay, fine. So, alums are what? Which type of compounds alums are? Last 15 seconds, students. You know, every center mark, I'm giving you different sets of questions related to this chapter only, so that you can be prepared for any set of exams. Okay, answer is, alums are nothing but a mixed salt. Now you will ask, sir, what is mixed salts? Okay, I helped you by telling the word salt in the when I was talking about the question. I know many of you have answered because of that. But if you knew also, it's fine. What is the alums, you know? Alums are like, one is the very famous alum, that is potash alum. Potash alum. What are the alums? Alums are the mixed salt. Mixed salt, or you can say the double salt. They are the double salt. Double salt means the combination of two salts are called as double salts. Example, means A2SO4 dot Al2SO4 whole thrice dot 24H2O. There are two salts present, K2SO4 and aluminium sulfate. So mix these two salts are known as, when there are two salts, we call it as a double salt, and they are called as alums. This is actually a potash alum. Potash means potassium, and there is a aluminium. There is one more compound which is known as Mohr salt. You will learn this in class 12th. Mohr's salt. That is also a double salt. Formula is ammonium sulfate. In place of potassium, you will get ammonium. That's it. Ammonium sulfate. Now, iron sulfate. Dot 6H2O. You will have sulfate in common in these alums. Sulfate must be there. Ammonium and iron. Is it clear to you? So two simple salt always form double salt, and that is nothing but called as alums. Any doubt? Could I move to next question? Sure. If anyone has any small doubt, you can ask. Don't think your friends are not asking, so you should also remain quiet. No doubts? I'm moving to next one. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Fine. Next question. Okay. Now, this is the leaderboard. Good, Aryan, Aniket, Meghna. Moving to next question. Which of the following is quick lime? You can answer it quickly. What is the quick lime? It should not take much time. Please answer it fast. What is quick lime? ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट 20 सेकेंड्स. ओके फाइन. ओके आंसर इज सीएओ. नाउ आई वांट टू आस्क यू वन क्वेश्चन. एस क्विक लाइम इज सीएओ. व्हाट इज स्लेक लाइम? व्हाट इज स्लेक लाइम फॉर्मूला? स्लेक लाइम CaOH whole twice. Very good. That is slaked line. Okay. What was the third one? CaCO3. What is its common name? CaCO3. CaCO3 common name? No. Limestone. Very good. Don't write marble. Limestone. One is slaked lime. One is lime. Quick lime. One is limestone. What was the last one? CaCl2 dot 6H2O. What was CaCl2 dot? Yes, eggshell have CaCO3. What is the name of CaCO3 dot 6H2O? Any idea why I gave this question? To tell you the names of all the compounds. CaCO3 dot 6H2O name is? This is that compound. Tell me what is name of this? Okay, just think about POP. What is the name of POP? What is name of POP? Plaster of Paris name is calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Calcium sulfate hemihydrate. What is name of CaCl2 dot 6H2O? Think. Very good. Answer is calcium chloride hexahydrate. Understood how to write name of the compounds? This is how we write the names, and these are the names whenever you have the water of crystallization. Okay, fine. Students, we are going to solve next question now. Any doubt in this? Do you have any doubt? No, there is no, we don't have common name. This is the calcium chloride dot hexahydrate we say. Understood? Any other doubts? No doubts? Sure. Could we move to next one? Fine. Marble is CaCO3. Marble is calcium carbonate itself. Yes, means major constituent is calcium carbonate only in marble. Any other doubt? You know, that's why when you have a calcium carbonate and with acid rain, you know that marble monuments are getting eroded because of or that get corroded because of the acid rain. Because in your acid rain you have H2SO4 and this is nothing but marble. So in acid rain, what will happen? Tell me. Why the marble monuments get eroded due to the acid rain? Who can answer? Okay, because it will give you CaCSO4 dot H2O plus CO2. So reaction goes in forward direction. It keeps on going in forward direction because CO2 gas is forming, and that's why marble get eroded. Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you? Yes? Okay, fine. Next is yes, moving to next question. We'll see leaderboard first. Sneha, please mute your mic. Yeah, this is happening to Taj Mahal. You must have heard that Taj Mahal, that thing is deteriorated because of this acid rain only. Okay, same thing happened with HNO3 also. In place of HNO3, what will be the product? What will be the product if HNO3 is there? Calcium carbonate plus HNO3. Double displacement. No. Nitrate will form. Calcium nitrate. Like this. Calcium carbonate plus HNO3. If it is a diluted one, not concentrated one, what will be the product? Calcium nitrate. Whole twice. Two times. Plus H2O. Plus CO2. Is it clear to all of you? Is it clear? Yes. Fine. Moving to the next question. Very good, Aniket, Aryan, Megha. Plaster of Paris is obtained. Plaster of Paris is obtained by adding water to calcium sulfate. Seems good option. By adding sulfuric acid to calcium hydroxide. Not bad. By heating gypsum to very high temperature. Oh, gypsum we have learned few minutes back. We learned about gypsum. Okay. By heating gypsum to 2373 Kelvin. Maybe we must have heard about something heating, but we don't know what is the answer in this case. Let us see. Okay, please use your brain. Think what will happen when calcium sulfate is added to water. Okay, students. Answer for this. My dear students, this time I am expecting 100% result. Oh my god. Students, this thing I told you in previous question. Gypsum is CaS. Oh my god. See. 1 minute. Okay. Just a minute.
Sir, one doubt. Isn't gypsum heated to 120 degrees Celsius to get POP and not 100 degrees Celsius? 373 Kelvin is approximately 100 degrees Celsius, right?
Okay, so now what is your doubt in this?
So should it
sir, be sealed? Saying that it's 100 degrees, it's 120 degrees, not 100 degrees.
Fine, means it's around like. You should not see options if you go around the temperature options given. I think I discussed this point in previous question. If you heat this to very high temperature, your calcium hemihydrate means you will not stop the reaction at, or you can't stop reaction at calcium hemihydrate. Did you understand? Yes or no? So if you want to, you have this reaction, let's say, calcium sulfate. .2H2O and you are heating this and you want to stop reaction at calcium sulfate .0.5H2O and your 1.5H2O water will leave the compound. Yes? So now here if you heat it with very high temperature, what will happen? If you heat with very high temperature, you have to think about the best options. Okay. If you see the best option, what is the best option if you heat a very high temperature? If you heat at very high temperature, what you are going to do? It will be calcium sulfate dot 2H2O. Okay. And this may also dissociate. So generally we say it should be around 100 degrees Celsius. Okay. There is no fixed temperature. You can't say it's a fixed temperature, but in general, we say it's a 373 is nothing but 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so you can say around 100 degrees Celsius, you should heat the calcium sulfate dot 2H2O. Is it clear? Any doubt? 1 minute. If you have any doubt, please ask. So why is plaster of Paris called? Okay, you will learn it later. Plaster of Paris, we will say, well, I'll tell you why, what is the reason behind this. Any other doubt? Because it was originally, yes. What else? It was used to cover walls and buildings in Paris. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, what any conceptual doubt you have, first please clear that, then I'll clear your all other doubts. Yes. 1 minute. It is used in the, yes. Any other doubt? Is it clear? Someone asked me about the temperature. What was your name? What is your name? Please tell me. Please tell me your name. Anirudh. Anirudh, is it clear? It is around 100 degrees Celsius. But if they say 110, you won't say no, it won't form. There are chances it will form. But that's why the option is quite clear. Gypsum to very high temperature will break. Will break the compound and remove all the water. Understood? So generally we keep the 100 degrees Celsius. Is it clear, Anirudh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Moving to the next question. What happened, Ananya? Okay, it's no doubt, fine. Okay, next question. Of the aqueous solution listed below, which would be the best conductor of electric current? You have just 1 minute. Which would be the best conductor of electric current? Concentrations are given to you. Concentration is M. Think it's very easy question. No, M is not mole. It is a kind of mole only. Okay, fine. It is kind of mole. Now think. It is kind of mole only. Yes, it is molarity. But those who don't know molarity, they can consider it mole. Then solve. Then also you will get the same answer. Okay, time's up. Let us see how many of you got the same answer. How many of you got the correct answer? Oh, 34 of you have marked it right. Very good, students. This question is very easy. You need to think like, okay, first of all, I want to tell you what the molarity is. Molarity, those who don't know, molarity is nothing but moles divided by volume. Moles of solute divided by volume of solution. This is molarity. Okay, why I said that you can consider moles only? Let's say my volume is 1 liter. If volume is 1 liter, if volume is 1 liter, implies molarity is equals to moles. That's why I told you, molarity equals to moles. Now, you need to think which will be the best conductor of electricity. There are two things which can conduct electricity. There are two things only. One is electron. Two things can conduct electricity. Always remember. No other thing. One is electron and second is ion. There are two things which can conduct. Electrons can't conduct in aqueous solution. Very rarely they conduct electricity. So not in aqueous. Not in aqueous solution. But they conduct in which case? Tell me, where they conduct electricity? Electrons? Where they conduct? In metals. In metals you have electrons as a conductor. But there is one more thing which can conduct electricity, are the ions. These ions conduct electricity in aqueous solution. In aqueous solution they conduct electricity. Now the question arises, sir, fine, more the ions, more will be the electricity conducted. Yes or no? Can I say like that? More the ions, more will be conduction. Now you think, which among these will give you the more number of ions? Which among these will give you the more number of ions? Okay, now you have to think. So this is HCl, strong acid. Strong acid. Completely break. HCl completely break into H plus and Cl minus. two ions it is giving. So one molar, if I consider one mole of it is giving one mole of H plus, because I have taken one mole of this. If you take one mole of this, you will get this one mole and this one mole. So total 2 moles ion. Total 2 moles of ions. Okay, fine. We'll see the next option, B. B is nothing but, what is the B? CH3COOH. Please check. Is it the acetic acid? Please check, am I right? Is it the acetic acid? Yes or no? No? B option? B option is CH3COOH only. They have written in different way. Just look at this. CH3COOH. It is weak acid. It is weak acid. So it will give you CH3COO minus plus H plus, but it is in the reversible, since it is a reversible reaction. Yes, you can write like this. You can write like this. What is actual difference in option A and D? We'll come to that. We'll come to that. First you tell me, did you understand that it is not giving you 2 moles? Could I remove this? Could I erase everything? Could I erase everything if you understood whatever I have done? I want to explain B, C and D. Okay, fine. So, if you see the option B, B is nothing but acetic acid. It won't break or it won't dissociate 100%. It will dissociate but not 100%. So, out of 1 mole, you can say it will dissociate, let's say 40% it dissociate. So 0.6 moles of this you will have, 0.4 mole of this will have, and 0.4 mole of this you will have. Means out of 1 mole, if 0.4 is breaking down, 0.4 will form, 0.4 will form. Total moles of ions. How much total moles? Total moles of ion. Quickly tell me, students. Total moles of ions. I'm just giving you an example. Not 100% dissociation. Yes. Total moles of ion. 0.4 mole of CH3CO minus and 0.4 mole of CH plus. 0.8 mole. Very good. In A part, I told you HCl gives you H plus plus Cl minus. You got 1 mole and 1 mole. Total 2 moles ion. 2 moles ion. This means that answer is not B. Answer is not B. This is very clear. Moving to the option C. Alcohol. Alcohol is nothing but it is dissociating very less. Same thing. Dissociation, not 100% dissociation. Not 100% dissociation. So this is also not our answer. Last is HClO. My dear student, HClO4 is very strong acid. HClO4 is very strong acid. It dissociates 100%. Very strong acid. But who told you HClO is a strong acid? It is weak acid. HClO is a weak acid. It won't dissociate 100%. Yes, HClO4 is very strong. Stronger than HCl. HClO4 is very strong acid. Understood? Any other doubt? So HClO is a weak acid. If I would have given you option HClO4, then that would have been our answer. But option has HClO, that is a weak acid. Hope you understood this question. Okay, HClO4 is quite very strong acid. We call it as the strongest acid. Okay, so HClO4, HIO4, all these are strong acids only. But HClO4 is quite very, very strong acid. The correct, okay. What is pH? pH depends on concentration. pH depends on its concentration. Understood? What about aqua regia? That is not as, that is a very good oxidizing agent. Aqua regia is very good oxidizing agent. Definitely that is also a strong acid. But its major purpose is to oxidize something, not to neutralize something. Yes, that is also acid, because it is formed by acid and acid. That is also acid. but it is oxidizing agent, so it oxidizes everything. Okay, don't worry. Aqua regia is nothing but HCl plus H, mixture of HCl and HNO3. We use to dissolve gold. We use to dissolve native metal. To dissolve native metal, we use aqua regia. Don't worry. Next chapter, metals and non-metals, I am going to discuss this in detail. Okay. Could I move to next question? Okay. Okay, pH could be negative. I will tell you in which case. You know, the actually practically saying it's not possible, but theoretically you can get negative values if you have a very very concentrated thing, means it's kind of solid only, then you can get the pH negative, but practically it's not applicable, because as soon as you add water it will have some concentration. But theoretically you can say it is possible. Understood? Okay, next question. Okay, fine. So two more questions you have, I think. Please read this question carefully and then answer. Whatever concept I applied in previous question, please apply it here. I told you something about concentration in last question. Okay, last 10 seconds. My dear students, this question was very easy. I am assuming that 100% result will be there. Let us see. Oh my god. 27 only. Fine. Question was very easy, my dear students. I told you in the previous question, see, I told you when CH3COOH breaks, it will give you 1 mole, 1 mole. Here 0.6 of this will, 0.4 is breaking. Here it's 0.4 mole is breaking, it will give you 0.4 and 0.4. Because the stoichiometry is 1 and 1. Stoichiometry or coefficient is 1 and 1. Try to understand. I'm moving to the next question. Try to understand how to solve that. This is the question. Na3PO4. Whenever it breaks, if you write a balanced chemical equation, it will give 3 Na plus ion and PO4 3 minus ions. Now, same thing. Molarity is moles divided by volume. Let's consider volume as 1 mole. Volume is 1 liter, sorry. Just assume volume is 1 liter. This means molarity equals to moles. Molarity equals to moles. If you can say molarity equals to moles, you have 0.250 moles. If you take 0.250 moles, my dear students, tell me if 0.250 will break, how many Na will form? If 1 Na3PO4 gives you 3 Na plus, 0.25 moles will give you how many Na plus? 0.750 moles. This is answer. Any doubt? If anyone has any small doubt, please ask now. This is the last. There is one more question. Again, fine. Aditya, whenever you write the reaction when Na3PO4 is a salt, when it break down, when it dissociate, it will give you 3 Na plus. Okay, how if you take H2SO4? I'm just giving you an example, and because you have done this so many times. When you have H2SO4, it breaks down, what it will give you? When it breaks, oh, two more questions. Okay, students. When H2SO4 breaks, what it will give you? 2H plus, plus SO4 2 minus. Same thing apply here. Why 2H plus? Because 2 hydrogen you have. Here you have 2-3 sodium, so 3 sodium ions. Am I clear, Aditya? Yes or no? Okay, answer is 350. Moving to the next question. Okay, students, I'll skip the leaderboard this time. I want to go to questions. We don't have much time now. Okay, fine. Which of the following is weakest base? Please answer it fast. Weakest base. Assuming 100% result this time, because probably this is the last session for acid bases and salt. Probably this is the last one, so I hope that you can, okay, I may take one more if I'll bring some new concept in that centaur also. But I'm not going to take these things again. What is weak acid, weak base, salt and all. Okay, it's very easy. Last 10 seconds, students. Okay, my dear students, the weakest acid is NH4OH. Weakest acid is NH4OH. Most of you have answered it right. Okay. And CaOH whole twice is also weak, but not weakest. That is also weak. Sorry, I meant base. Sorry. I meant base. Weakest base is NH4OH. Understood? Last question. Okay, this is the leaderboard. And we are on last question. Who is leading? Oh, great going, students. Last question. Let us see who can change the leaderboard now. Which salt can be classified as acid salt? Acid salt. Which salt can be classified as acid salt? Very easy question. Just think of it. Okay, last 10 seconds, students. Okay, acid salt, I told you one day to remember. Basic salt and acid salt. Acid salts are those salts in which all the hydrogens are not leaving the compound. My dear students, acid salt I asked. Acid salts are those salts in which all hydrogens are not leaving the compound. So this is acid salt. Actually, it was H3PO4 earlier. When it reacts with NaOH, H3PO4 reacts with NaOH, first one hydrogen is removed. First one hydrogen is removed, so it will form H2NaPO4. Then H2NaPO4 further reacts with NaOH. Then it will give you HNaPO4. Then it further reacts with NaOH. Gives you Na2Na3PO4. So overall we write like this. Whenever someone asks you, write the reaction for H3PO4 with NaOH. What you write? 3 times of NaOH. You do the double displacement. Na3PO4 and water. You do the double displacement directly. PO4 go with Na, OH minus go with H. But these are the 3 steps. So they have asked acid salts means the salt which has not lost all of its hydrogen. So you are getting this compound. So it is nothing but acid salt. Acid salt. Can I call this also as acid salt? Can I call this also as acid salt? Yes or no? Acid salt. This is basic salt. This is basic salt. It has not lost its all OH minus. This is basic salt. Is it clear? This is simple salt. Simple salt. Hope you understood this. Hope you understood. Could I show you the results now? Okay, fine, students. Sorry for extending class. And this is your final result. And let us see who is. It seems like Meghna is going to win. Let us see, Momita or Meghna. Okay, Meghna, congratulations, Meghna. Well done. Aniket, Aryan, Momita, Sneha, all of you have done great. Congrats to all of you. Now, if anyone has any doubt, they can ask me. And those who want to leave, they can leave. Okay, students. So, I think all of you have cleared your doubts. Yes? Sir, does it always remain H2 in a strong acid salt? Sir, does it always remain? No. Hydrogen should be there. Let's say NaHSO4. NaHSO4 is also acid salt. H should be there for acid salt. For acid salt, H should be there. Could you show third question? Third question. Fine. Third question is this. Just a minute. This is third question. This is the electrolysis of NaCl. Gives you NaOH, Cl2 and H2. Yes, I told you fourth one in 10th question only. I told you about the fourth question in 10th one only, that bleaching powder is CaOCl2. When you put into water, it will give you calcium hydroxide. This is actually not precipitate, but it is milky white. It is milky. You know, calcium hydroxide, that's why it is not a strong base. It does not dissociate 100%, but it is milky in color. Understood? No, calcium carbonate, there is no source of carbon. Where is the carbon in these two compounds? Nowhere you have carbon. Tell me. Nowhere you have carbon, how you will get the carbonate? Understood? 12th one. Okay, wait. Could I move to 12th one? All clear before this? Yes, 1 minute. 12th one is this. Okay, my dear student, 12th one is like strong acid dissociate 100%. So the things which will give you more number of ions, that are the good conductor of electricity. HCl break into H plus and Cl minus completely. CH3COH is weak acid. CH3COH is weak acid that won't break into this completely, not 100%, means you will have less number of ions as compared to H plus and Cl minus, because here HCl completely break into H plus and Cl minus, but here CH3COH is not completely breaking. Am I clear? Same thing is applicable for all of these. Yes, my dear student, Na3PO4 is a salt of strong acid with strong base, as means not strong base, but it will dissociate 100%. Na3Na plus plus PO4 3 minus. Okay, you can say not 100%, but extent of dissociation is not bad. Not bad. Understood? But you can say it's almost 100%. Molarity is nothing but, molarity is a concentration term. It is nothing but moles divided by volume. This you need to remember as a formula. It is a concentration term. Moles of something divided by volume. If I say 2 moles of NaCl, I have added in 100 ml of water. What is the molarity? What is molarity? 2 divided by volume in liter. Volume in liter is nothing but 0.1 liter. So answer is 20. Is it clear, Arain? Arain, did you understand? Please take your time and reply. Okay, students, everything clear? Could we stop here? Yes. Okay, thank you, students. Bye. Hope you learned something today, something new. Okay, good. Bye.